The mayor of New York returning to the scene of one of the most devastating fires in the city's history. Officials now announcing a change in the death toll.
We have 17 lost, 9 are adults and 8 are children.
That number expected to rise, with more than a dozen fighting for their lives in the hospital.
My cousin, I heard that his 3 children passed away, but we don't know where the wife is. I don't know where's my cousin and his wife. Yeah, now I'm trying to go to the hospitals. Look for them.
The fire tore through this high-rise Bronx apartment building Sunday just before 11 a.m.
I drop on my knees and start to pray to God and ask God, please help us. Help us. It was too much.
Officials say a space heater malfunctioned, causing a mattress to burst into flames.
We were sleeping and then my kids screamed, say fire, fire. So I don't go to the room. So I see the fire in the mattress. So I told everybody, get out, get out.
Investigators discovered the apartment door was left open along with a stairwell door, the thick, heavy smoke spreading fast.
Close the door. Close the door. That was embedded in my head as a child.
Now the main focus, those open doors. In 2018, the city passed a law mandating self-closing doors in all apartment buildings.
The law is only as good as its enforcement. The property owner claims that the building did in fact have self-closing doors. But that's the unanswered question at the heart of the investigation, the fire marshal's investigation. If these doors were self-closing, then why was the apartment door left open?
Local officials are helping those who have been displaced. Others will be allowed back in sometime this afternoon. Rena Roy, ABC News, The Bronx, New York.